Hi everybody, welcome back to my channel. So as fall has arrived and it looks like winter here where I live because a few snowflakes have fallen, I am getting into the mood of holiday baking. And when I think about holiday baking, I know this is probably a year-round thing, but I usually think about caramel, apples, pies, that sort of thing. So today I attempted to make caramel apples for the first time. A little bit of the process was a fail. I tried to revive it. I wasn't sure if I was gonna post the video when I was halfway through with it, but I went ahead and still decided to edit this video. I will show you how I failed, how I fixed it, another part where I failed and fixed it again, and let me show you the final result so that you can continue to watch. And also the reason that I did this, that I decided to post my failure anyway, is to show you that even though you started or you start to practice something that you've never made before, to still continue through the process, start it, continue it, and finish it so that next time you know what you did wrong and so that you can prove to yourself that you can always keep practicing and get better at it. Obviously, I plan to practice these apples and I hope to one day be better. No, I don't hope. I am gonna be better at them one day. So here's how they look. This is what we're making today. They obviously didn't look like this throughout the entire thing. So I am gonna show you how I failed, how I fixed it, and how they turned out like this. So let's get right to the video. The first thing that I'm going to do is to clean my apples. As you can see here, you can see some of the wax that is on my apple. So I have a pot of hot water and I'm adding in a quarter cup of white vinegar, and I'm also adding 1 tablespoon of baking soda. And this concoction is going to help to loosen up the wax from the apples. Now I'm going to start dipping my apples into this water, and I did set a timer, so every time I put apples in, I leave them in there no longer than 10 seconds, otherwise your apples will cook. And just in case you haven't made apples like I hadn't before, the reasoning for this step is to make sure that we remove the wax so that the caramel or the candy that we are using sticks to the surface of the apple. And here you can see that the wax has been loosened up. It's those little specks of white. So I did go ahead and take a textured kitchen towel and I rubbed off all of the wax in all of my apples. After I finished with this step, I did go ahead and submerge my apples in a clean bath of water and clean them with a completely different towel to make sure that they were wiped clean and dry for the next step. Now here is the part where everything started going wrong, and this is the making of the caramel for my apples. I will place the exact measurements that I used for this caramel in the description box. I did go ahead and add butter, brown sugar, I put in a little bit of corn syrup, and I also used vanilla as my flavoring, as well as sweetened condensed milk. And again, all of these ingredients and the measurements will be listed below, and you will see what I'm talking about later on in the video as to why everything started going wrong. So for caramel, in case you haven't made caramel yourself at home before, it is recommended to use a candy thermometer, especially if you are trying to reach different textures. For example, soft caramel, hard caramel. In this case, I wanted to bring my caramel up to 245 degrees to the point where it was a little bit soft, but not to the point where it was falling off my apple. This process did take approximately between 10 to 15 minutes, so I did go ahead and speed up this portion of the video. During this part, I was still very confident that everything was going to work out, and I was just waiting for my temperature to reach 245 degrees. And as you can see, after a while, my caramel did start bubbling and it did start to reach that temperature. This is the part where I added the vanilla, and not necessarily where everything went wrong, because it was already wrong before it started. But as you can see from here, it does look a little bit oily on the sides, and I thought that this was normal, not because I haven't made caramel before, but I just thought that this was the normal for this recipe. So I did go ahead and swirl it with a little spatula for a while. And then I just decided to go for it and dip it. And this is what happened. My caramel was just not sticking to the apples, and I just thought that I was dipping the apple wrong. For a minute, I thought that I had not cleaned my apples the right way, or that I didn't wait enough before dipping my apples. So at this point, I did want to throw away the caramel, but I decided to give it another try and do some research. But before all the research, I did say, you know, maybe it's just that one apple, and I took another apple, dipped it, and the same thing happened, and the caramel was just not sticking. And at this point, I still didn't know that the problem was the caramel, and you can clearly see it on the apple. So upon researching, I did find that obviously all of your ingredients have to be at the same temperature. I did do this video at a spur of the moment, so I threw in my butter and it was ice cold, literally from the refrigerator. It was not at room temperature, so the shock between the 245 degrees and the fact that my butter was not at room temperature was what caused the separation. So essentially what I did is I turned on the stove again, and on very, very low heat, I slowly started to stir my caramel to the point where all of the ingredients were at the same temperature, and luckily it came back together, as you can see here. Not too perfect, some bubbles, but I still went with it because I had already gone through the trouble. Now here's the second part where everything went wrong. Initially, I used to use Wilton candy melt and they worked fine, as long as you added some vegetable shortening. For some reason, I do believe that they have undergone a change in their formula or the way that they make this chocolate. So for some reason, it didn't work for me. And at the end of the day, when it was melted, it took a long time to melt. And then it was just a little bit, I don't even know how to explain it, but it was breaking on me. So some parts of it were hot and then other parts were just not coming together. So I threw it away and started over with this almond candy coating. And I did go ahead and melt it in my same Wilton pot, added a little bit of vegetable shortening, and here is the result. Now, for this part, what I did wrong is that I did not wait for my chocolate to come back down to temperature. And I immediately took it exactly as it is here, which was very hot, and dipped my apples, causing it to be very thin and allowing all of my mistakes, the little bubbles and the little crevices, to be noticeable. And you will see that here. And as you can see, along with that problem, my chocolate was not entirely melted, and there was little pieces of chocolate that had not melted. Regardless, at this point, I think I was so frustrated and I wasn't willing to give up and throw away these apples because I had already invested too much time and effort into them. So what I did is I stood here, I dipped all the apples in this runny chocolate, I allowed them to dry, and at the end of the day, what I did is I let them dry overnight, and I said, you know what, I'm just gonna come back tomorrow and finish them.
It is now the next day, and what I decided to do is I remelted the chocolate that I melted the day before. And as you can see, here's how my apples dried. They're not very pretty. You can see some of the caramel, you can see a little bit of holes and bubbles, and I just decided to re-dip them again, added another layer, and I said, you know what, if this doesn't work, then at least I tried. But, and you can see the rest of the apples here, they are all very thin, so the layer of chocolate is not even thick enough to cover the caramel. So I re-dipped everything twice and let them dry. And then, as you do in cakes, I said, well, maybe I can cover the bumps, the holes, and all of the crevices with some sprinkles. So I took a little bag and I placed some of my chocolate into this bag. I left my warmer on so that the chocolate wouldn't get hard inside the bag, and I simply cut a tiny little hole and just kind of swirled it onto my apple and added these sprinkles from Sprinkle Pop. In case you are curious, this is the hashtag blessed Sprinkle Pop mix, and I think it worked pretty well. So I tried several different things and several different ways of adding these lines. At the end, I think I was very satisfied with how the first apple looked, so I just continued with that look rather than with this, where I skipped a few spaces and you would be able to see some of the crevices and the bumps. So I'm going to let you watch what I did to the rest of my apples.
Okay, so now that you saw the entire process, it was a little bit crazy. It was a little bit wild. I wanted to cry. Literally, my husband walked into the kitchen and I was like, you ruined it, it's ruined. And he felt so bad. It really wasn't his fault, it was my fault for the caramel or caramel at first, and then the chocolate. Like, literally, it just wasn't working for me. But I've had these apples and this project like in my head for so long, and I thought it was gonna work. I thought everything was gonna go great. I thought it was gonna go smooth, and I was like, yes. Like, for a minute, I thought to myself, and this sounds a little bit arrogant, but I was like, I can do other things. Like, these are just apples, right? Like, I got this. But I don't got this, girl. I don't got it at all. I need a lot more practice. They turned out pretty okay for my first time. They have some bumps, they have some bubbles, they have some weird aspects to them, but overall, I think I did pretty good. So yeah, hopefully next time that I bring you a apple video, they turn out better than this time. So I have a cutting board here. This feels like I'm doing a mukbang or a mukbang, whatever that's called. So I'm gonna cut it and I'm gonna see how they turned out. They're so good, you guys. They might not be the prettiest, they might not be like the coolest ones, the coolest apples like on the block, and I might not be like a super like apple pro, but they turned out delicious and they turned out great. So now that you've seen the entire video, don't forget to give this video a like if you liked it. If you try it, let me know in the comments below. Don't forget to share this video, this failed video, with your friends. And subscribe before you go. I'll talk to you next time. Bye.